students, now we'll be studying the law of refraction of lights. Okay, see, in the previous topic, okay, we studied about the law of reflection, right? And also again I taught you what is refraction also, okay? And now we'll be studying about the two laws which governs the refraction. But I want to just give you brief of the reflection, law of reflection, okay, so that you understand the refraction better, okay? See, this is the picture I have drawn for reflection, and this is the picture I have drawn for refraction, okay? See, in case of reflection, what is the first law is that angle of incidence, angle of reflection and normal lie at the same point, okay, in the plane, okay? And here also it is said same. See, the incident ray, the refracted ray and the normal to the interface of two media at the point of incidence all lie in the same plane. It is also saying the same thing, that is angle of incidence, angle of refraction, okay, and the normal will lie at a same point, okay, in the interface of two medium. Okay, why it has been said interface is because, see, here there are two medium involved, that is why it is talking about interface of two medium. Okay, but in case of reflection we don't write interface of two medium, okay, we only say the angle of incidence, the angle of reflection and the normal lies at the same point of the incidence. See, where they are lying, when the point of incidence, how we make normal, right? I already explained you that the normal is always made at the point of incident, where the incident ray just where the incident ray strike, at that place we make a normal. Okay, in this case also, as soon as the incident ray it is striking, okay, as soon as the incident ray is striking, the normal is, we make the normal and we get the angle of reflection at the same point. Here also, as soon as the incident ray strikes, we get a normal and then we get angle of reflection also at that particular point only. Means first law holds good with both of them, okay? Both of them follow the same first law, that is angle of incident, angle of reflection and normal lies at the same point, okay, of as lies at the same point, okay, in the place of incidence, okay? But only the difference is we will be writing at the interface of the two medium, or that part can be omitted also. Main thing is that you mention all those three things lies at the same point. Now another thing is the ratio of sine of angle of incidence to the sine of angle of reflection is constant for the angle of a given color and for the given pair of media. This law is also known as Snell's law of refraction. This is true for the angle 0 is less than incident, and if incident angle of incident is more than 0 and less than 90 degree. If I is the angle of incident and R is the angle of refraction, then sine I by sine R is constant. Okay, what does it mean is, see, our law of reflection, it says that angle of incidence, okay, angle of incident, it is equal to the angle of reflection. Okay, this is what the law of reflection says. But the law of refraction says somewhat different, that is sine I by sine R is equal to constant. Okay, there is a difference between both the law, in the second law. Okay, first law for both the thing are same, but the second law for both of them are there is a slight difference. Okay, one is like angle of incident is equal to the angle of reflection, okay, but in the next case sine of I divided by sine of R is equal to constant, and this thing is like it is constant for a particular medium. For example, sine I divided by sine R for glass and air, okay, is 1, for example only I am telling, okay, but it is like is 1, for example. That means you take any glass at any place, okay, and you draw this kind of, you try to make this kind of figure, if you do sine I by sine R, okay, sine of incident, angle of incident, and sine of angle of reflection, you'll get same value, okay, no matter where do you do that, okay. And if we take the next medium, for example, if we take air and ice, okay, from air it is the light is hitting the ice. If we do that, then again the sine I by sine R will be different as compared to this one, but that will also be constant for any ice you take, okay, any ice of any size or anywhere you take, okay. That means every time for a certain medium, okay, sine I by sine R will always be constant, and this law hold good only when angle of incident is less than 0 and more than 90 degrees. All right.